subduction, making magma, and the formation of granitic mountains. Let's use the geology of Joshua Tree National Park to demonstrate. Starting around 200 million years ago, North America broke away from Pangaea. Moving westward, subduction started along the western margin of the North American continent between the North American plate and the Farallon plate. From about 200 million to about 30 million years ago, subduction generated huge volumes of magma, which rose up through the crust as plutons. The plutons rose up through the crust, eventually solidifying at depths of 10 to 15 miles deep. The rock through which the plutons intruded is known as the host rock, or the original rock of the continent. In the case of Joshua Tree National Park, this rock is called the Pinto Gneiss. One of the granitic bodies that intruded into the Pinto Gneiss is known as Palms Granite. Over time, the Palms Granite was slowly brought to the Earth's surface through the processes of erosion and isostatic uplift. Eventually, the granite, as well as the overlying Pinto Gneiss, are exposed at the Earth's surface. The Pinto Gneiss is referred to as the roof pendant to the Palms Granite, as it forms a geologic roof over this granitic body. Today, Ryan Mountain at Joshua Tree National Park offers an excellent example of a roof pendant, where you can see the dark brown Pinto Gneiss overlapping the Palms Granite, which had intruded from beneath.